हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल मेकाजी मॉस। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फोर्स, और यू कैन से क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लोड। सिंस वी नो दैट द फोर्स इज दैट विच चेंजेज और ट्राई टू चेंजेज द स्टेट ऑफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, देन दैट इज कॉल्ड द फोर्स। सो हाउ द फोर्सेस इज क्लासिफाइड? A force can be classified into three ways. According to the effect on the body, a force is classified into five categories, that is tensile force, compressive force, shear force, bending force and twisting force. But if you will classify the forces according to the application on the body, then it is are two types. One is dead load and another is live load. And according to SFD and BMD, the force is classified into concentrated force, uniformly distributed load, uniformly varying load, combination of UDL and UVL, and moment load. So today we will discuss one by one what are the different types of forces. So let us start. According to the effect onto the body, the force are classified into five categories: tensile force, compressive force, shear force, bending force and twisting force. So tensile force is that force which tries to increase the length of a body. Suppose there is a rectangular block of length L and a force is applied like this. This force will always try to change the length of the body. That means try to increase the length of the body, rectangular block. So this type of force is called the tensile force. So you should remember, if a force increases the length of an body, then it is called the tensile force. And similarly, if a force is acting on the body in such a manner that its length is decreases, then it is called the compressive force. Now third type of force is the shear force. Very important classification. So you should know about the shear force. Let us suppose there are two plates which are connected with a riveted joint, and a force is applying onto the upper block in this way, and another force is applying onto the block in this way. So due to the application of this force, what will happen? If you will see the cross-sectional area of the riveted part, then this force will try to shear off the rivet. That means एक ऐसा force जो किसी object को तोड़ने की tendency रखता है, shear off करने की tendency रखता है, वैसे force को हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं? Shear force. So if you will apply this type of force, it will tries to shear off the object. Or here you can see the riveted may fails like this. So this type of force is called the shear force. Another type of force is called the bending force. Let us suppose there is a cantilever beam and a force is applying onto the body. So this force will always try to bend the initial position of the cantilever. So this type of force is called the bending force. And another type of force is called the twisting force. Let us suppose there is a circular shaft having one end fixed, completely fixed, and a force F is applied on to the other end. This force is acting tangentially. So if you will look the cross section of this circular shaft and consider arbitrarily any two points A and B, then on the application of this force F, the position of this point may change or twist like this. may be chances, there may be chances, one point may be shifted on to the A dash point, A point is shifted to A dash point and B point is shifted to B dash point. So if a force having tendency to twist the cross section of an element, then this type of force is called the twisting force. So this is the first type of classification of the force. Second way of the classification of the force is according to the application of force. According to application of force, there may be of two types of force or two types of load. One is the dead load and another one is the live load. So dead load is that type of load which arises due to the weight of the structure. Always remember, weight of the structure itself or any other things which are connected to that structure. So the load applied by the structure's weight is called the dead load. And if the load is applied temporarily, then that type of load is called the live load. For example, you can see here is a pic of a train moving onto the bridge. So agar hum maan le ki abhi filhal ye train is bridge ke upar nahi hai, तो जो ब्रिज का जो लोड है वो लोड ऑलवेज क्या होंगे, इस पिलर के ऊपर, चूँकि ये पिलर के ऊपर सपोर्टेड हैं तो इस ब्रिज का वेट पिलर के ऊपर एक्ट हो रहा होगा, ठीक है। तो दैट मीन्स दिस द वेट ऑफ द ब्रिज इज कॉन्स्टेंटली अप्लाइड ऑन टू द पिलर ऑफ द ब्रिज, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ लोड इज कॉल्ड द डेड लोड। And suppose a train is moving on to the bridge, that means this, if you will consider the weight of the train which is coming on to the bridge, the weight of the train acting on the bridge is an example of the live load. So this is the temporary load. Once the train is coming, load is applying and train will move, then load will be the released. So this is the two types of load, dead load and live load. Another way of classification of the load is according to the SFD and BMD. So according to SFD and BMD, there are five types of load: concentrated load, uniformly distributed load, uniformly varying load, combination of UDL and UVL, and the moment load. So today we will discuss only the concentrated load. After that, in the next video, I will cover the uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load. So what is the concentrated load? Concentrated load is the load which is concentrated to a point. What does it mean? Let us suppose a fan. Take the example of a fan which is hanging onto the roof. So a fan hanging onto the roof is an example of a point load or concentrated load. Why? If you will see, the weight of the fan is acting at this point, and the rod through which it is connected to the roof, it can be concentrated as a point as compared to the cross-sectional area of the roof, because the cross-sectional area of this bar is very small as compared to the cross-sectional area of the roof. So this load can be considered as a point load. Similarly, a man is standing onto the ground surface is also an example of a concentrated load. How? Because if you will see, the weight of the man is acting through its feet onto the ground surface. So if you will consider the cross-sectional area of the feet, then its cross-sectional area is very very small as compared to the cross-sectional area of the floor. So we can consider it as a concentrated load. एंड ए कंसंट्रेटेड लोड कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड लाइक एन सिंगल एरो सिंस इट एक्ट्स ऑन ए पॉइंट दैट्स व्हाई दिस कंसंट्रेटेड लोड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ए पॉइंट लोड. So this is all about the today's lecture. In the next lecture, I will cover the uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load.